Today, we're going to talk about using the native Twitter analytics that's included with your Twitter account. So when you log into Twitter, this is normally what you see. Actually, what you do see is this just this massive stream. And if you go up in the top right and you click on the gear icon, select Twitter ads. Now, I'm not going to suggest that you're going to buy a Twitter ad. That's not what we're here to talk about. What you have is you have the ability to look at your basically analytics. Okay, so you go to Twitter ads. Up at the top, if you click on analytics, this drop-down menu, and you look at tweet activity, okay, what you're going to do is you're going to get a report for the past 28 days, and it's going to show how many impressions. Okay, and there are three, key measurements that you're going to look at when you think about how effectively you're using Twitter, just in general. Okay, and that would be engagement, okay, link clicks and retweets. All right, engagement is you definitely want conversations on Twitter. You want to have a back and forth because you want to build a community, right? But you also want to drive traffic to your website. So Twitter's showing you link clicks, and Twitter's also going to show you retweets as well. Retweets is critical because if someone retweets, say, a blog post on your website, what does that mean? It means that their followers are going to see that in their stream on Twitter as well. So that just creates more exposure for your website. And then finally, favorites, right? So you can see people favoriting and also people replying, okay? And if you mouse over any of these charts, you can kind of drill into each one of these. You can see how many link clicks, okay? Now, this is very, very high level, but you can export all the data. If you're an Excel wizard, that's great. You can use it that way. You can also see your own tweets and how many impressions the tweet has received and what the engagement rate is on the tweet, okay? Now, engagement rate is this. It's the same as on Facebook. Engagement rate is basically the percent of people that saw the tweet that reacted to it. They retweeted it, they replied, they clicked on a link, they clicked on the tweet to view it. In fact, it does say here, if we mouse over any of these definitions, it says engagement, the total number of times a user has interacted with a tweet. This includes all clicks anywhere on the tweet, including a hashtag, links, avatar, username, tweet, expansion, retweets, replies, follows, and favorites. Okay, so that's engagement. And then engagement rate is these two numbers together. In other words, 407 people saw the tweet, right? 407 people were presented the tweet. Two people reacted to it. So as you can imagine, the higher the engagement rate is, that's really an indication of the quality of the tweet, okay? So if we scroll down and we look at something with a very high engagement rate, let me just go and look at this one right here, okay? Is a donate button coming to Twitter? That has a 2.3% engagement rate compared to the others. That seems pretty high, relatively speaking. So this might be something that I can copy and I can actually paste. I can drill into the tweet details as well, okay? So this is just showing you link clicks, user profile clicks, replies. It digs down a little bit deeper into the information on each tweet. But the value of this in my mind is, okay, this is really great analytics, but this gives you a tweet that, you know, you kind of can depend on, okay? This is a high engagement rate. This means this is content that we can possibly use for the future. So we can grab this, we can go up in the right-hand side of Twitter, and you're going to love this next feature. If you click on the tweet button that we all know and love, it's different, okay? Watch this. I'm going to copy and paste this tweet into, you know, Twitter, right? And I can choose to schedule it. Now, this is not available with the regular Twitter. Like if you just go to Twitter and you click on the tweet thing, you just get this box. And we all know, actually, I was working on composing a tweet here. It's kind of funny. A carrier pigeons beat internet speed as late as 2010. I just thought it was an interesting fact. I'm going to tweet that now. But yeah, as you can see, I can't schedule anything within Twitter ads. We can schedule it, okay? So now I'm going to just quickly go over here and schedule something for Friday afternoon, okay? Or maybe even early next week, I don't know, okay? So we'll schedule the tweet, and we're all set. So that is now scheduled, right? Now the other place where we can get information about our tweets about how we're doing on Twitter is we can also look at Twitter cards, okay? Now, Twitter cards are basically rich media is applied to a tweet, okay? So I was desperately trying to find examples of Twitter cards, but basically a normal tweet looks something like this. This is a normal tweet that we all know. A Twitter card has more information in the tweet itself. It might have a description about a link. It has a could have a call to action. It could have an image. But within the Twitter card module, we can look at snapshot. This is basically saying 43 tweets in a specific within 28 days. So there are 43 tweets that are Twitter cards, impressions, link clicks, talks about changes over time. And then we see card types. Okay. So mostly what I've done is I've created a summary card and a player, actually just a summary card really is what I've been generating. And I'm doing that with a WordPress plugin called WordPress SEO by Yoast, Y-O-A-S-T. That will automatically create Twitter cards in, but you have to install it as a plugin in WordPress, configure it, it's super quick, and then that will enable you to create Twitter cards pretty easily, okay? We also have links here, so it shows you the links that have been publishing, right? So these are links in tweets with Twitter cards. So these are generated automatically using that plugin, and it's showing impressions, link clicks, and all that. And what I really love about this section is that we can see influencers. This list right here is absolutely important. Twitter is about reciprocity. If you retweet someone else's stuff, they might come along and retweet your stuff. There's that type of reciprocity that's involved in Twitter. So you can find out, you know, who's retweeting my stuff, who's engaging with my stuff, who's spreading the word about my nonprofit. And then you can obviously return the favor as you see fit.